I know that x of s equals 1/5 over s plus 1 plus 2/5 minus j 4/5, that's what this is, over s plus 3 plus j 4, and then I got the complex conjugate of that. 2/5 plus j 4/5 over s plus 3 minus j 4. All right, great. So now how do we find, this is easy to find the inverse Laplace transform, right? That's just going to be 1/5 1 e to the minus t. But what about this? Well, let's solve this in a general manner so we can develop a rule such that, you know, regardless of what the coefficients are for this, once you get it in this form, we can jump straight to the answer. So let's generalize. Okay, and let's say that I'm gonna let this part just equal y of s. Okay. So if I have an equation y of s and it equals let's say m minus j n over s minus phi minus j omega, and I have another one, it's going to be the complex conjugate of that, m minus j n s minus phi plus j omega. So this is, right, it's exactly the same form, it's just that m equals 2/5, n equals 4/5, phi equals 3, minus 3, omega equals minus 4. Can I develop a rule for this? Well, let's just assume, let's almost kind of ignore the imaginary parts for a second. You know, if I had A over S minus B, that would, the inverse Laplace transform of that would be A times E to the BT case. Or A times E to the minus negative BT. So anyway, if we apply that same kind of logic down here, we could say, well, Y of T equals, you know, this doesn't have any S's in it. It's just a number. So I could say, okay, well, it's like A. M minus J of N. And then this is like our B. E to the, in this case, if I pull that minus sign out, you know, instead of it being S, that would be S minus phi plus j omega, right? E to the phi plus j omega t, right? That's what this piece equates to. This one plus m minus j sub n e, if I pull the minus sign out of this, it's going to be phi minus j omega, phi minus j omega t, right?